In this tutorial, we will show you how to convert an older DC model to DCC. We have shown many AC models so far, but for our new module layout, we need some steam locomotives, as we cannot use our regular models from the main layout. At the last train show, we bought some used ones, but they were all DC, so they need some conversion. We bought this Roco Prussian T12, which is actually a French TC10. Many of these locomotives were left behind after the First World War, so they ended up in various companies. This tutorial is for older models of this series, as Roco released a revised version in 2010. We did some research before doing the conversion and found a forum post by Mark aka Guardian71 on a German forum. See the link in the description. This video is based on his post. First, we test to see if the locomotive actually runs, which it does. Then it's time to remove the body. There are two screws underneath the coal and the other at the front underneath the boiler. I tried to open it before this video and messed it up. That's why the body looks crooked, but it will be fixed. Next comes the most important step of the whole conversion: isolating the motor. It was very common on older models for one of the motor's terminals to be connected directly to the chassis. Using this configuration would fry the decoder in a matter of seconds. To do this, remove the circuit board from the top and lift the motor out. The left terminal is already isolated, but the right one has to be modified. We unscrew the right motor terminal and remove the brass washer. I use a piece of paper to insulate it. In this case, it was a piece of Märklin M-track insulation that I had lying around. I drilled a hole and put the terminal back in place. Then I trimmed the paper. We put the motor back and checked that it is now isolated. Next is a quick test to make sure it still works. It is very important to test and measure each step of a conversion. This way you can eliminate mistakes at once, without having to go through a long process of troubleshooting. The next step is common to all our conversions: replacing the bulbs with LEDs. We chose warm white LEDs and soldered a 1 kΩ resistor to the cathode and a blue wire to the anode. A quick test to make sure it works before gluing the LED to the existing light pipe using Bondic UV glue. Now it's time to connect everything to the decoder. We soldered the motor terminals to a grey and orange wire and removed the old contact from the board. Unsolder everything from it. On the PCB, we scrape off enough copper to solder all the plus connections to the LED. Make sure it's well isolated from the rest of the circuit. For the decoder, we use a LocPilot 5 micro from ESU. The author of the tutorial suggests using sheet metal to make a decoder mount. As we don't have any, we used the 3D printer to make one. Then we glued it in place with the Bondic and mounted the decoder on it. We have to cut all the wires to the correct length, as there is not much room. Then solder all the connections. For the track connection, we use the original black wire for the left side, and the right side, the red wires, are soldered where we can have a connection to the chassis. Before we finish the conversion, we put the locomotive on a test track, update the decoder and program it. Then we check that everything is working properly. If it is, we insulate all the solder joints with Bondic and fix the wires so that they do not move. As a final step, we put black paint where we have solder to hide it. Then we put the case back on, taking care not to pinch any wires. This happened to me and I had to redo the front LED. So one last test to complete the conversion. So that's it. We hope this video was useful. If you're converting a locomotive yourself, check out our other tutorials, such as the one on adding complicated lighting schemes to a locomotive.